So we have limits, a numerical and graphical approach. So as what you can remember, we have already introduced or have a shallow discussion on limits for the last module, sa midterm. So we have identified there that we can use limits sa slope and sa tangent line. Okay. So limits. So let's define thoroughly what is a limit. So one important aspect of the study of calculus is the analysis of how function values, that's our outputs, change as input values change. So basic to this study is the notion of a limit. So suppose a function f is given and suppose the x values, so your x values natin are our inputs, get closer and closer to some number a. So if the corresponding outputs, the values of f of x, get closer and closer to another number, then that number is called the limit of f of x as x approaches to a. Okay, so kumbaga, if we have a function, given function, and then we have values of x, so if that x is closer and closer to that number, then yung sagot ng f of x is closer and closer to another number. So, ano yung another number na yun? That is the limit or yung sagot niya, closer and closer. Okay? So, for example, let f of x be 2x plus 3 and select x values that get closer and closer to 4. Okay, so yan. Ito na yung nasa table sa baba. Okay? So, we see that as the input values approach 4, so dito sa mga x natin, from the left, that is, are less than 4. So if we say from the left, mga less than 4 yan siya, the output values approach 11. So dito yung mga sagot niya approaches to 11. And as the input values naman approach 4 from the right, so that means more than 4, yan, or greater than 4, the output values also approach to 11. Same lang yung sagot nila, yan. Okay? So this is from the left, this is from the right. Okay, so we say that as x approaches to 4 from either side, the function 2x plus 3 approaches to 11. So yan. Okay, so if we graph this, so ito yung graph niya. So it is approaching to 4. So yan dyan. Okay, so either side ng limit na 4, ng given value, x na 4. So either from the left or from the right. The answer is approaching to 11. So that's the concept of limit. Okay, so kumbaga, as x approaches a, the limit of f of x is L. So yan. So it is written as the limit of f of x as x approaches to a. So yung arrow na yan, ang pagbasa niyan is as x approaches to 4 or as x approaches to a. So kung ano yung nandyan. So an arrow is often used to stand for the words approaches from either side. So thus the statement above can be written as x approaches to 4, 2x plus 3 approaches to 11. So the number 11 is said to be the limit. Okay, ng function na 2x plus 3 as x approaches to 4 from either side. Then we can abbreviate this, ito dito, as this one. Limit of 2x plus 3 as x approaches 4 equals to 11. Okay. Yan, so ito yung definition ni limit. So given a function as x approaches to a, we have L. So L is the limit of the function. If all values of the function are closer to L, for values of x that are sufficiently close but not equal to A, the limit L must be a unique real number. Okay, so here itong A na to, kumbaga kahit na anong number ni or anong value ni x dyan na sufficiently close to A, here itong limit na dito. Okay, so then we have this L. We can find L. Then that is a unique real number. So that's the limit. So when we write this one, the limit of f of x as x approaches to a, we are indicating that x is approaching a from both sides. So pwede siya from the left or from the right. So if we want to be more specific, then we can use this one. to dito. So, A, negative. Okay, so, kumbaga, this is from the left. Kung may A positive dyan, that is from the right. Okay. So, we have this theorem. So, as x approaches A, the limit of f of x is L. If the limit from the left exists and the limit from the right exists. And both limits are L. So, kumbaga, kung dito tayo, balik tayo sa table kanina. So, this is from the left, this is from the right. So, lahat sila nag-exist. Then, the limit L exists. Kasi nag-exist yung limit from either side of A. Okay, so, for example, we have the function 3x minus 1. Okay? So, let's have our x as 6 or our a as 6. So, we need to choose any number closer to 6. So, from this is from the left of 6 and this is from the right of 6. So, sa nakikita natin dyan. So, from the right of 6, so 17, approaching to 17 yung sagot. From the left naman of 6, still approaching to 17 yung sagot. Therefore, we can say that the limit of this function 3x minus 1 as x approaches to 6 is 17. Yan. So, that is how we visualize or find the limit of a function using graphical method. Okay, now let's proceed to how we can find the limits of a function using algebraic method. Here, we have this one. Okay. So, for example, we have x squared minus 1 over x minus 1. So, first is what is f of 1 and what is the limit of f of x as x approaches 1. So, f of 1, so this is just a substitution. So, just substitute the value of x, which is 1. So, 1 squared minus 1, 1 over 1 minus 1. So, the answer is 0 over 0. So, this answer does not exist since this is indeterminate. Okay? So, kumbaga, wala siya sa real number system or hindi siya natin ma-graph. Okay? So, for A, this is the answer. Does not exist or 0 over 0. Okay? So, but if we have the limit, this one as x approaches to 1. So, this is from the left of 1. This is from the right of 1. So, you can see may sagot naman. So, that means may limit siya. Okay? Kasi may sagot siya in either side of the limit or the A. So, yan. So, ito na yung table na nakita natin. So, we select x values close to 1 on either side. So, dito. And we see that the function values get closer and closer to 2. Okay? Closer to 2, closer to 2. Thus, the limit of f of x as x approaches 1 is 2. So, kumbaga, hindi pala ito ang totoong sagot. Okay? But, if you are really to substitute directly this one, so, the answer is really 0 over 0. But, if for the limit, using this method, then we can see that there is a limit, which is 2. So, yan. So, kaya dito, pag graph natin, ito yung mga coordinates. So, pag graph natin dyan, may halo yan dyan at 1, 2. Okay? So, the graph as a whole at the point 1, 2. Thus, even though the function is not defined at x equals to 1, the limit does exist as x approaches to 1. So, as x approaches to 1, the value of our y approaches to 2. So, may hole yan dyan. 1, 2. Okay, so mamaya sa mga rules natin or properties ni limit, so we can still solve for this one na makukuha natin si 2. Okay, kasi may mga rules or mga properties na pwede nating magamit para hindi tayo makakuha ng sagot na 0 over 0. Kasi usually kapag nagsosolve tayo ng limits as much as possible, we need to try na hindi undefined or na dapat nag-exist talaga yung mga sagot natin basta sa limits. Okay, so let's have another or the other way of solving limits. So that's the algebraic way. Okay, let's have the algebraic. So if we say algebraic, we are using operations and functions. Okay. Anyway, we have a lot of examples and nasa modules natin, and then you also have there some of exercise problems. Okay, here. Algebraic limits and continuity. So using numerical and graphical methods for finding limits can be time consuming. Okay, in this section, we develop methods to more quickly evaluate limits for a wide variety of functions. So we then use limits to study continuity, a concept of great importance in calculus. So we have here algebraic limits. So consider the functions. We have f of x equals to x, g of x equals to 3, and f of x equals to x plus 3. So ito yung mga graphs nila. Okay, so as what you can see, walang hole yan dyan. Okay. Suppose we are interested in the limits of f of x, g of x, and f of x. Okay, so saan sila approaching? So if we have this one, dito, if x approaches to 2, so the limit of f of x equals to 2. Kasi nga, we have f of x equals to x. So if the value of x is 2, then definitely the limit here is 2. And then g of x equals to 3. So as x approaches to 2, so the answer is still 3 because we can't substitute the value of x here, which is 2. So, kaya 3 pa rin yung sagot niyan dyan. Dito naman, f of x equals to x plus 3. As x approaches to 2, so ang limit nito is 2 plus 3, that is 5. So, kaya nandyan. Okay. Kung negative 1 naman, yung as x approaches to negative 1, so kung balik tayo dito, okay, so f of x or the limit of x as x approaches to negative 1, so the answer here is negative 1. Dito naman, the limit of 3 as x approaches to negative 1, that is still 3. Kasi hindi natin nagamit yung x. And then dito naman, limit of x plus 3 as x approaches to negative 1, so that is negative 1 plus 3, that's 2. So kaya 2. Ito yung mga sagot, negative 1, 3, and 2. Okay, from these results, the following observations can be made. So dito sa mga examples dito, may mga ma-observe tayo. So for any real number A, limit of x as x approaches to A is A. Yan. Kasi ito lang naman. Eh. All you need to do is to substitute what is the value of x here. So yan dyan. Kung A yung value niya dito, so definitely your limit is A. For any real number A, limit of 3 as x approaches to A is 3. Since wala kasi tayong x dito, so hindi natin nagamit yung value ni x, which is A. So kaya 3 pa rin yung sagot. So this is a constant rule. Okay. And then recalling that f of x equals f of x plus g of x. To make this reasonable conclusion. So for any real number A, the limit of x plus 3 as x approaches to A is equal to A plus 3. Kasi nga, x is approaching to A. So kaya yung x natin dito, substitute natin yan sa A. So A plus 3. Okay, now we have this property. So these are very important for us to solve for the limits. Okay, so first property. So we are going to use these properties in solving limits for us not to have undefined answers or undefined limits. So the limit of a constant is the constant. So limit of C as x approaches to A is C. So kano yung constant dyan, that is the answer. Then the limit of a power is the power of that limit. So this one. Okay, the limit of f of x raised to the power of n as x approaches to A is equal to this one, the limit. So ipalagay lang natin sa loob ng groupings and then find the limit of the function as x approaches to A raised to the power of n. So that is L raised to the power of n. And then the limit of a root is the root of that limit, assuming n is a positive integer. So, yan. So, dapat positive integer itong index dito. Okay? So, yeah, all you need to do is kailangan lang ilagay sa loob ng radical sign itong limit. So, we consider limit here as an operator just like subtraction, addition, multiplication, and division. So, as you see addition sign, so that means you need to add them. Dito naman sa limits, so kapag nakita agad sa limit, so that means you need to apply the rules or properties of limits to solve. Yeah. So in case of the root, we must have our L here should be greater than or equal to 0 para hindi imaginary ang sagot. Okay, so dapat real number. Then we have L3. The limit of a sum or a difference is the sum or the difference of the limit. So just add the limits of the function of f and the function of g. And then, or subtract them. And then the limit of a product is the product of the limits. Okay, so just multiply the product of, just multiply the limits of the function of f and g. And then the limit of a quotient is the quotient of the limit. So yeah. So just distribute the limit operators sa ating denominator and numerator. Yeah. And then we have the limit of a constant times a function is the constant times the limit of the function. So kapag may constant dyan, for example, 3x, so the constant should precede the limit operator. So kaya dapat maging ganito siya, C limit of the function. So yan. So C limit of the function, so C times L. Okay, so again, if ever may constant, so for example, 3x squared, so 3 limit of x squared. So, ganun dapat. Yan. So, we have here, for any rational function naman, f with a in the domain of f, the limit of the function as x approaches to a is equals to f of a. So, all you need to do is to substitute what is given here dito sa function. Okay, so we have example. So first example natin is this one. So we have, okay, so we have the limit of x squared minus x minus 12 all over x plus 3 as x approaches to negative 3. So dito muna tayo sa medyo simple na example. Ito muna tayo sa unang example. Yan. So we have the limit of x squared minus 3x plus 7 as x approaches to 4. So using the properties of limits, okay. So using the properties of limits, so we have this one. So we have the limit of x squared as x approaches to 4. So first is distribute this operator na limit sa ating tatlong terms yan dyan. Minus, so this is 3x, so 3 limit of x as x approaches to 4 minus the limit of 7 as x approaches to 4. So, what you can see, yung ginawa natin dito is distribute yung limit operator. Then we can now solve using the properties of limit. So dito, limit of x squared as x approaches to 4, that is 4 squared minus 3. Then limit ni x as x approaches to 4, that is 4. Kasi value ni x is 4. Okay, minus the limit of 7 as x approaches to 4. So this is constant. So that means whatever is the given constant, that is the answer. So 7. Next, we have 4 squared, that is 16. Minus 3 times 4, that's 12. Minus 7. Then we have 16 minus 12. That is 4 minus 7, negative 3. Yeah. So this is now the answer, negative 3. Any question for the first example? Di ba kami mali? Question? Here pala. This is addition. Wait. Addition pala to. So plus 7. So this should be here. This should be 11. Yeah. So here is 11. question? I'll proceed to another example. Here. Okay. So we have the limit of x to the fourth minus 5x cubed plus x squared minus 7. Okay, so we have, so first distribute the limit. So limit of x to the fourth as x approaches to minus 5. Limit of x cubed as x approaches to 2 plus the limit of x squared as x approaches to 2 minus the limit of 7 as x approaches to 2. Okay, now apply the properties. So we have the limit of okay, here we have limit of x to the fourth as x approaches to 2. So we have 2 to the fourth minus 5. Here 2. Okay, so limit of x cubed as x approaches to 2. So 2 cubed plus the limit of x squared as x approaches to 2. So that is 2 squared. Minus the limit of 7 as x approaches to 2. So that is still 7. So here we have 16. So 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, that's 16. Minus 2 cubed, that is 8 times 5, that is 40. Plus 2 squared, that is 4. Minus 7. Okay, here we have 16 plus 4, that is 20. Dito naman, negative 47. So we have negative 27. So this is now our answer.